people, welcome to Shifting Gears, and with me I have the KTM RC 200. This is the second generation motorcycle. This is the 2022 model year motorcycle. And in this video, we are going to check out what changes have been on this bike. How radically different is it to look at? What are the mechanical changes? What are the new features that you get? And should you buy this motorcycle for your sport biking requirements?
Ex-showroom prices for this new KTM RC 200 begin at ₹2,09,000. And yes, over the years, the KTM RC 200 has become expensive. But then, there is no direct 200cc class rival to this super sport machine. KTM has been setting and maintaining benchmarks in the budget sport biking segment for years now here in the Indian market. Fun fact, what you pay for the KTM RC 200 now is what the KTM RC 390 demanded when it was first launched. First, let's talk about the ergonomics. My height is 5 feet 8 inches and for me, this motorcycle feels and fits just right. The tail end of this motorcycle is high, so you have to make an effort to swing a leg so that you don't hit the grab rail and scratch it or hurt yourself. Foot pegs are rear set and you are in a sporty forward leaning stance. The seat not only looks good but offers decent room for you to move around. Handlebars are still of the clip-on type, demanding you to lean forward. Everything fits right and you won't face any problems in terms of functionality. It is easy to even kick the side stand out. 835mm of seat height and 160kg of curb weight is easy to manage. Two big changes to make note of. For India, KTM is offering us a full LED headlamp as standard on the RC 200. The export models do not get it. Also, the clip-on handlebar on the India spec motorcycle is height adjustable. You get a 14.5mm range to move it up or down to suit your body type and riding style. So that's a noteworthy effort to add more value to the KTM RC 200 here in India. Quick revision, powering the 2022 KTM RC 200 is a 199.5cc single cylinder liquid cooled DOHC motor producing 25 PS of power and 19.2 Nm of torque matched to a 6-speed gearbox. Power to weight ratio is 156 PS per ton. Coming to the features, this is an all new motorcycle. Well, almost. The bodywork is brand new and it has no resemblance to the old KTM RC 200 at all. While most did not like the looks of this motorcycle judging from the images, the bike does look good in person. The brand claims that the bodywork is MotoGP inspired and aerodynamics was the key focus here. The new panels are easy to remove and fix, and also the fairing provides better wind and weather protection now. While you have two paint options, this silver and orange shade is our favorite. This time the fairing doesn't cover the underbelly section too much, and that has resulted in better cornering clearance. The full LED headlamp is flanked by LED DRLs on either sides, and you also get fairing integrated turn indicators now. The mirrors are mounted on the fairing and you get a clear bubble-shaped front windscreen. The split trellis chassis is contrast painted. The 13.7-litre larger fuel tank has two contrast painted covers on top. Split seats which look the part on a premium motorcycle. Orange painted new designed alloy wheels. Fully reprofiled rear section now since the pillion seat is not integrated. New LED tail lamp. New rear fender. Adjustable rear monoshock, upside down front fork, dark themed rear swing arm, and lastly an underbelly exhaust which in our opinion looks a little unfinished. The pillion seat can be opened via the keyhole between the two seats, and on the left hand side of the motorcycle you get a sari guard too. Pillion grab rails are a new addition to the RC and they are painted in black. Another new feature on the motorcycle is the LCD speedometer cluster. This is unlike what you see on the 390 Duke and 390 Adventure. This is not a color display unit and there is no Bluetooth connectivity either. Information shown here is plenty, such as digital speed readout, digital tachometer, gear position indicator, shift light, clock, trip meters, odometer, distance to empty, mileage info, trip time, average speed, etc. The cockpit view is modern and sporty, but we wish that the Bluetooth-enabled unit from the KTM 390s was used over here just to add more value. But then that is just wishful thinking. Some key highlights: the new rear subframe of this motorcycle, which is a part of the lighter split trellis chassis, is different compared to the Duke models. The double foam seat is narrow between the legs to allow riders to have their feet flat on the ground easily. There is a 40% larger airbox underneath as well. The radiator is 10% larger in size and is a single fan curved unit. The front disc is a 320mm unit, while the rear disc is a 230mm unit. Tire sizes have remained the same. Ground clearance has improved to 158mm, and the wheelbase of this motorcycle has also increased, which is 1347mm now as opposed to 1341mm before. KTM has managed to keep the weight in check even with all the changes. There is a reduction in the unsprung mass, which makes the new RC200 easier to ride and flick around. Total 3.3 kg of dry weight has been reduced, out of which 1.1 kg has been saved from the wheels, and the rest of the weight saving comes from the hubs for the brakes, both the brake discs, rear sprocket, and the hollow axles at both ends. The old and the new bike both weigh 160 kg. But you are getting a lot more with the new machine now. Now, most of these changes, you will also see them on the new KTM RC390 and RC125. However, both of these motorcycles have been delayed due to the global supply chain problems caused by the pandemic.
So guys, kaisi lagi aapko ye new generation KTM RC200 sports bike? Ye aap hame comments mein zarur bataiye. If you have any other queries about this motorcycle, do ask me. I will try my best to help you out. Goodbye. Ride safe, always wear your helmets and follow those speed limits.